Hi everyone, my name is Kaustubh Kale. Trust you're doing absolutely fantastic. So why should entrepreneurs or business owners consider investing in other businesses or equities? People ask me this as a common query that I am already in control of my business. I am investing in my business. Why should I invest in other businesses? So let's understand this with something which is very simple. When you are in control of your business or when you are running a business as a business owner, you are devoting your time, efforts and money to it. But when we tell you to invest in equities and other businesses, our intention is to build a portfolio of passive income where your stocks or mutual funds will basically grow by itself. The money works when even while you're sleeping and you don't have to give any time or efforts to it. You have to just devote money. So that is why you need to have a passive income bucket where the stocks and mutual funds grow by themselves and you're investing in the India growth story. There is another reason why we tell people should invest in other businesses. That's because of a bias, a prejudice that many business owners exhibit. It's called as illusion of control bias, endowment bias, overconfidence bias, where they feel that because they are in control of their own business, they will do an absolutely amazing job. But what we tell people is that you are anyways investing in your own business. Also consider other businesses, and you may at some point of time feel that the other business is actually more lucrative for you to invest more. And that is how we talk about investing. My recommendation to business owners always is to try and stick to India's top 50 or top 100 businesses, which are large cap companies. This way, you're not just betting on your own self by investing in your own business. You're also betting on India's growth story by investing in the top 50 or 100 entrepreneurs of India. And that is how it should also be, because it's important to diversify risk and not have all eggs in one basket. This way, while you're also devoting time to your business, you're ensuring that at some point of time, you will have a bucket or a portfolio of stocks or mutual funds which will take care of your expenses and you will not have to continuously run or focus on your own business. That is basically what the intention is of financial independence. Now, if you want to invest in other businesses, what is the approach that we recommend? The approach that we recommend, like I earlier said, is invest in the top 50 or top 100 stocks of India. Have a proper investing philosophy. The other thing that you can do is you can just invest in a large cap mutual fund or an index fund and just take part of India's growth story. Thank you so much, everyone. I hope this made sense for you. Thank you.